So I have a question for you. How much time do you spend on social media every week? I'm not just talking about writing it either. Oh, and don't get me started on finding that perfect image that goes with the text that you just wrote. Creating compelling content is only one of the keys to social media marketing success. There really is so much more that needs to go into it to really genuinely build your audience and convert your followers into customers. And here's a little admission for you. So lately, I've been spending way too much time on growing my Instagram. I've been testing some things out, but I generally believe that it's been worth every second. You know, social media channels like Instagram and Facebook, they offer small businesses like ours invaluable and remarkably pretty inexpensive advertising options. And they allow us to reach potential customers from everywhere inside your target market and maybe beyond. And the upshot of all of my Instagram work is that I began to develop a system that really works. The only problem is that it takes up a lot of time. And unfortunately, that's unavoidable. I mean, there are so many companies out there on Instagram and all the other social media networks that you really do need to spend time on the social media platforms to set yourself apart. And the one thing that I think so many people miss out on when it comes to social media is the social part. But thankfully, there is a really good shortcut that will probably not only save you hours of time every week, but will also give you an expert insight into how social media works. Hire a virtual assistant, specifically a virtual assistant who is an expert in digital marketing and social media marketing specifically. So how can that help? Well, you know, you can actually get your social media growing at pretty nice rate with about 20 minutes a day. And a lot of that does go into the content that you're creating. Without the content, you know, your social media pages are going to look pretty sad. They just are. Even if you're retweeting or reposting content from other profiles, which you definitely should be, I mean, you definitely, that's the networking part. You really need to be generating your own content as well. And that's where you're going to really differentiate yourself from your competitors. So, with that in mind, spending time to write posts every week is well worth the effort. However, if you don't have a ton of experience in social media, it can take a lot of time to write those daily posts. You'd think that sitting down and writing a post, you know, even if you're doing it day by day, would be easy, but it's not. And that's especially true when you're a small business owner and you have a million other things to do on your plate and social media, along with other content creation, usually gets pushed kind of to the end of the to-do list or the back burner, or I forgot to do it, it didn't happen. By hiring a virtual assistant to write all of your social media posts for you, you not only free up precious time in your day, but you also have those building blocks that you need to really boost the social media engagement. And what's more, the more that you work with your virtual assistant, the better that they'll be at capturing your voice on social media. And it won't sound like someone else is writing your content for you. Instead, it'll sound like it's coming right out of the horse's mouth, well, so to speak. And incidentally, this is true, whatever kind of content creation that you hire or partner with a virtual assistant to create. So if they're writing a weekly blog for you, the more that they do it, the more that they'll capture your voice. So when we start working with a new client, we have a really great copywriting intake document that we send that really helps us gather all of this different information that really helps us to capture their voice and then create our copywriting core documents that we use when creating content. And that's why building a strong long-term partnership with a virtual assistant can really pay off. And then there's graphics. So your social media, of course, needs to be more than just words. It's a very visual medium. And with that in mind, having that graphical component to your post, it really attracts eyes and it sets you apart from the people who just post text-only content. You see that a lot on Facebook or Twitter. And with that said, your content needs to look really good design-wise, like really good. After all, terribly designed graphics, they might attract eyes, but not in the way that you want. And after all, you know, think about it like this. Everyone, unfortunately, checks out a car crash, but car companies don't use them to advertise, right? And hiring a virtual assistant that's really experienced in graphic design to create the content for your social media, you'll have that visual component that you need to really engage with people and get people to engage with your content. And it's even better if you have the same virtual assistant doing all of your social media content. That way the graphics and the text will really pair well together and will seem very seamless. And then of course we come to scheduling. So as a small business owner, you don't need me to tell you the importance of scheduling and batching your time. If you aren't making every single minute of your day count, then you're simply wasting time. And the same is true for social media, really is. There are high times of engagement on social media. And if you're not gauging that and posting your content at those moments, then you're really not getting the best bang for your buck. That's why effectively scheduling your social media is imperative. So personally, I like to schedule the same time that I write. And I've talked about this before, that I create all of my social media for the whole month in one day. Usually takes me a few hours. I usually get up early on a Saturday or a Sunday. I just sit down, I write out content for the whole next month. I, you know, find visuals, create graphics, create all my stories. I do all of it all at once. And then I schedule everything at once. I do my research, you know, for the month all at one time. That way it's scheduled, it's done, and I don't have to think about it for a month. And if you don't have time to sit down and do that, that's definitely something that I suggest hiring a virtual assistant to do for you. I know that a lot of people kind of go back and forth like, oh, I'm not sure that they'll capture my voice, or I'm telling you, if you partner with the right one, no one will ever know. My clients tell me all the time that their friends and family and clients will say how great their social media is looking now. And, you know, they're loving the engagement and the questions. And, you know, they have no idea that it's me doing it, and not the client. So let's go back to engagement. So again, I think this is where, you know, not only small businesses, but a lot of people kind of miss the mark when it comes to social media. So posting content obviously is fantastic, but unless you're getting engagement with it and getting people to engage with you, but also, you know, take those calls to action that you want, then it's kind of useless in terms of marketing. And that's where the effort really needs to come in. So let's take Instagram, for example. So in the past probably 6 weeks where I've really been focusing on it, I've been getting close to adding 300 new legit followers every week. And even better, my legit content interactions are up over 1,000%. So I'll drop a couple of links in the notes below so you can check out a before and after. But you'll see before where I would get a little bit of interaction, but it would kind of drop off from there. And then I'll add another link to show you what it looks like when I really put forth the engagement. You know, when I really put that energy and focus into it, you'll see me go from getting a couple of comments to tons and tons of comments. And you know, go from, you know, a few likes, maybe a dozen likes, to over 400 likes. You know, there's a big difference. And really that I've seen primarily coming from the engagement component. And, you know, I've been working really hard to connect with other Instagram users through engagement. And, you know, I've been also trying different techniques on, you know, how I structure the post. And, you know, it's been working really well and getting lots of people to interact. Okay, so here's another thing that I've noticed many small business owners miss regarding social media. So they focus only on their business. So people aren't using Instagram or Facebook to see ads. In fact, most people don't like ads. And the last thing that they want in their newsfeed is someone who's continually promoting their products or services over and over again. You know, what they do want is they want connection, they want value, they want entertainment. So with that in mind, it's really essential to really think of your social media as not just a business opportunity, but a way for you to provide more value and entertain and engage with your audience while you're providing that value. And you want to provide them with content that makes them go, ah, or you know, you want to inspire them. You want to get them thinking, you know, and that's one of the reasons why I occasionally feature my dogs. So I have Noodles the pug and Olive the French bulldog. And I'll be honest, I don't take enough pictures of them as I would like, but I do tend to post a lot of stories about them. So, you know, when I get off work, I'd like to go sit in the hot tub to relax. And especially, look, it's cold here in Florida today. When I got up, it was 50 degrees. So I'll definitely be getting in the hot tub tonight. But I love to watch them while I'm in the hot tub because they're silly, you know, and, you know, I don't mean to be biased or anything, but they are pretty darn cute. And my followers definitely agree. And so I like to share stories of them, and I get a lot of interaction and questions and likes. And, you know, if you don't have pets, that's okay. Maybe feature some other type of content, you know, that's fun. So if you're having maybe a lovely, you know, dinner out on your deck, you know, share it, you know, you will be inviting your audience into your life, and it builds a stronger personal connection with them. So it takes them from not just supporting your business, but to supporting you, right? So there's that person behind the small business that you're really supporting. And let's not forget about stories. So Instagram stories have been an incredible feature that many small businesses haven't yet worked into their social media marketing strategy. And that's a tragedy because, wow, if you do want interaction, stories really are the way to go. I think stories are really essential, you know, because they vanish so quickly, right? So they create that sense of urgency. So you might think that's the downside, right? Is that it's going to vanish after 24 hours, but really it's the opposite. And I find myself doing it. I follow certain people on Instagram. I see at the top that they have stories. It's the first thing I click on because I know they're going to disappear soon and I want to check it out. I want to know what they have to say. The stories really draw people in. And in fact, Instagram stories have become so popular that a lot of other social media, you know, platforms have started to offer similar functionality as well. A Facebook, of course, because they own Instagram, but I've also seen Twitter kind of playing with it a little bit. And that means that you really can't afford to skip out on stories. It's really a great way to massively boost your social media engagement. But again, the only problem with stories is that you can't just copy your social media content and stick it up on stories. You know, stories are a lot different. They need to be active and engaging and connect directly with your audience. You can do this in a number of ways. You could animate short videos that, you know, direct your viewers to your website or to other types of content. I do these a lot to promote my podcast or to offer people free workbooks, you know, something like that. But really, one of the things that I think really does so well is for you to get on video. You know, not only does it give your audience the ability to hear your voice, but they also get to see your face. And in a time where so many of us are feeling really increasingly isolated, being able to see the face of the person that you're going to be working with is really worth its weight in gold. And I can't recommend it highly enough. I don't do it enough myself. It's one of those things that at the end of the day, I always think, oh, I should have gotten on stories, but I'm very busy. And while I obviously can't record those short videos for you, I mean, it's you they want to see. I do have some clients that I do different types of stories for, you know, and I definitely write up scripts for stories. And, you know, I'm really helpful when it comes to, you know, creating different types of graphics for stories and, you know, maybe asking questions like, do you prefer this or that? Or, you know, taking polls. And of course, again, if you have a pet, get them on stories. You know, if you see them doing something silly or cute, you know, grab your phone, open Instagram and just give it a try. If you can weave it in to how you work in your business, even better. It's kind of like social media gold. So let's kind of recap what we talked about today. So proper social media engagement takes time, a lot of time. I mean, I think we all know that. I've been focusing on it, like I said, for the past month or so, and it takes up a lot of time. And writing social media posts can take up a large portion of that time, but that is something that you can hire a virtual assistant to really help you with, as well as creating graphics. And you really, if you're going to do your social media, and really if someone else is doing your social media, they should really sit down and do it all at once, you know, batch it all together, because you just save time when you batch your work. And if you want to increase engagement, especially on Instagram, then make sure that those graphics are like amazing. You know, your feed needs to look amazing. And all of your posts should be scheduled well ahead of time, you know, for peak engagement. You shouldn't be worrying about that at the last minute or, you know, in the middle of dinner. Oh, I never posted to Instagram. No, no, no. That needs to all be done ahead of time. But the real key to social media is the social part. You know, you really do have to engage. If you aren't engaging with your followers, you're kind of just shouting into the void. And you want to feature some content from your personal life. You want to give that emotional connection to your followers. And if all else fails, give your pets a try. They really are a social media goal. And really, let me know how it goes. I would love to hear. Give me a tag. I'll check it out. And of course, try directing your audience through Instagram stories. You know, get yourself on camera. You know, it's the best type of engagement. Get out there and ask some questions. And of course, if you're feeling overwhelmed by the idea of handling all of your social media, you can always reach out. I'm happy to answer any questions that you have. I have a ton of free social media resources on my website, everything that you could probably need to start building your social media channels and increase engagement across the board. For example, I have a really great holiday hashtag yearly calendar. I'll leave the link in the notes for you so you can check it out. I also have a download where I give you 15 free social media graphics just so you can check those out. And of course, I have the Making the Most of Your Social Media workbook so you can kind of figure out what's going to work best for you and your social media strategy. And of course, one of the biggest ways that I can help you with your social media engagement is by taking it off your plate. So, you know, with my team, we can do everything from research and creating social media strategy to writing posts and designing graphics to scheduling and engagement and ads, you know, everything that you could possibly need. So if you do want to chat, please reach out. I'll leave a link so that you can get some time on my calendar. You know, I think it's really a great time in the coming year to really think about partnering with an experienced virtual assistant, you know, to boost your social media, but then also maybe to help you with all the areas of your business. You know, you really need that right-hand person. Well, I hope you found this video helpful. If so, please subscribe. I like to put out content on a weekly basis. So if you're subscribed, you won't miss anything. And if you have any questions or thoughts or suggestions, please shoot me a note. I'd love to hear. I will see you next week. Have a great day.